Love Bucks, it's Roslynn back at you one more again. I hope everybody is doing blessed. I'm doing blessed and highly favored, and definitely hope the same for you. And if this is your first time stopping by my channel, much love to you and welcome into my returning subs, my growing, extended, beautiful family. Just thank you for taking the time out to see the signs that are coming towards your way to give you the answers that you desperately seek, whether if it's in a vision, dream, or just, you know, out and about and it just catches your eye. You know, those are all signs that the angels are trying to communicate with us. So that's truly a blessing to be able to experience. So with that being said, much love to all. Namaste. Love and blessings, love and light, and many blessings are definitely coming your way. And if you have been watching my videos for a while and have not already, please like and subscribe, hit that notification bell so you know when I'm about to upload my next video. Also, if you feel like you're comfortable now, please drop me a line or two. I love the chance to get to know you as much as you're getting to know me, even if it's about the positive feedback of the content of my video, or you're just up telling me about your empathic gift and how it impacts your life and heading you towards a positive direction. Also, if you feel like the video has been very informative to you or just gave you good vibes that you would love to share with a loved one, family, or a friend, please go ahead and do so. You know, even an empath, they're going through some trying times, need confirmation or validation towards their soul purpose or even their life path. Go ahead and share and give me a thumbs up. Also, share on your social media favorites wherever you see fit. And thank you once again for the love and support. And I hope you're able to resonate with the content of my video. And today, my meditation music I'm listening to is called Spiritual Emotional Healing Meditation, 528 Hertz. Release blockages and boost positive energy, and I'll place that link in the description box below. And my video is about Twin Flame 101, Heyoka's, when you can't move on from stressful situations, universe is helping you learn a lesson from your circumstances. And that is so true. You know, there's times, I mean, I look at my situation, I'll be angry as all get out. You know, just like, oh, I wish I can go on with this. You know, I'm tired of seeing the things that I see. You know, just having everything moving around me while I'm sitting still and stuff like that. And we have to really, really, you know, when you're, like I tell everybody, when you're in your emotions, it's hard to think about stuff that's positive that's going on. Or some people can, you know, they can turn to say, look at, you know, okay, what is this situation trying to teach me? What is it, you know, what is the hidden value behind this tragic situation? And it's just like when we have those stressful circumstances or we're enduring so much hardship in our life, you know, there could be things that we're not paying attention to, or where our mindset is set on negativity and stuff like that. Oh, first, before I get into that, I want to apologize to y'all about just cutting my video like that. I really wasn't trying to, but there was just like, they wanted me to talk about, you know, how we all have that power to be able to separate ourselves from childhood trauma as well as adult trauma. And it was a lot of things, just like from this meditation, it brought up a lot of things that I suppressed that I forgot all about. So it triggered me, like, I was like, oh Lord, you know, and I just burst out into tears, and I just didn't want to do that on camera, because there was a lot of things that I forgot about that I've endured as a child that, you know, I just rather not think about. And I had to make peace with that, and I had to tell myself, you have to make peace with that. That's a very messed up situation you had to endure, but, you know, hey, that came up for you to be able to release as well. So I had to really look at it that way. And, you know, that comes towards, you know, the situation I'm in, you know, I went through. You know, it's just like this situation had to allow me to be able to separate myself from the things they tried to make me be. You know, a lot of people will put you in a box and label you, and you're trying to undo everything that has been taught to you in the most negative way. You know, being able to love behind all measures, being able to forgive and let go, not because you're excusing the people's actions that placed this ugly situation on you, but being able to get that peace of mind that you desperately need. You know, because a lot of times people feel like, you know, why should I forgive people that did these things to me? They weren't sorry for doing it. No, they're not. But, you know, hurt people hurt people. You know, that's their line of communication, because they felt that was endured on them. So they feel like, you know, I'm going to endure this on this. You know, I'm going to put this person through the same thing. And some people don't realize, you know, how did that make you feel? when you were placed in situations like that? Did that make you, that person, love you anymore? You know, love you, you know, love, add more love towards you? No, that, it made that person really resent you, made them want to be able to get the heck away from you. You know, and a lot of people don't think about that. I mean, there's many times I had to tell my mom's ex-husband that, you know, because his father did the same thing to him. And he used to talk about how bad he hated his father. You know, you look at my grandfather and you can see he was very mean. You know, he gave out the energy like, if you even disagree with him, it felt like it was going to be an uppercut right after you disagree. So that was a lot of things that I had to see and actually know that my mom's ex-husband endured those things in his life. And it's just like, when I used to ask him that, he really couldn't say anything because, you know, he told me, you know, as soon as he turned 18, he joined the military and got the, you know, bunk ship. You know, they were living in Norfolk, Virginia at the time. So it was just like all those different things that he had to endure. He knew he hated his father for it. You know, nothing he could do ever made his father happy. You know, and he tried to do that, you know, but basically, I feel like he emulated his father a lot to his part. His dad didn't like who he was, so he couldn't stand who he was. Because it's like, you look at both of them together, and they look like twins. So I was like, oh my God, that's, you know, that's so scary. But, you know, seeing that, I had to be that one to break that cycle. Because it's like, I put my children through somewhat of the abuse that I endured in my life. You know, not by physical, but it was like emotional and verbal, you know. I mean, it's nothing I can say to make that change, because after things has been said, you know, I was only, you know, teaching what I was taught. You know, I can't sit up here, you know, I wish I could act like I was, you know, raised up in this nice, quaint, happy family with the white house and the picket fence. I wasn't. You know, I only taught my children what I was taught. You know, I had my children very early because I felt like I wasn't loved. So I had my children, you know, just for me to get unconditional love, because it's like, no matter what happened, they will always love me, and that's how I felt, you know. So I had to grow up really, really fast, you know, knowing that I did the same thing my mom did, except the only thing is I didn't give my children up for adoption. So, you know, my mom had me at 16, you know, my dad was 18 at the time, and then, you know, my first daughter, I was 16, and her dad was 18. So it was just a lot of things that, you know, I mocked that my mom did. So it's just like all these different situations you've been placed in, you know, it can be very stressful, it keeps you in a dark place. But you have to see what that lesson is trying to teach you. What is it trying to get you to know on the positive aspect? You know, it's allowing you, with my situation, is allowing myself to love myself beyond all measures, never taking anything less than what I truly deserve, being able to forgive and let go because you deserve happiness, and knowing your blessings are around the corner, knowing all the things that you went through, it wasn't just for nothing. You know, it's just like the universe allows us to teach, you know, that teaches us so many different things. At times, I'm not even gonna lie, I get pissed. You know, I'm just like, I said all the positive things that I do, you know, I know I'm not perfect. You know, I have my moments, but I said all the things I endure, you know, I go out and help people with, I shouldn't have to endure this. But then it's just like, you know, when things are coming towards your way, the universe never sees positive and negative. It just feels energy. So I was giving off that pissed off at the world energy. So that's what I got back. So I had to really understand that, you know, it's not the fact that they're trying to, you know, punish you. It's just, you got to be careful and mindful of the things you put out in the world. You know, I try not to cast judgment, especially towards people that has really pissed me off, you know, or, you know, I see them doing things. And my daughter even say, Mom, I was just trying to see what you were going to say. How you said it, I said, yeah, they even used my daughter against me on trying to ask, like, ooh, let me see how she going to reply back to this response and this and this and that. But, you know, you have to really understand, you know, the universe wants the best for you. God wants the best for you. You know, they have so many blessings and plans for you, but you have to be able to let go of those things that keep you at that low vibrational place, get you in that dark place. You have to be able to let go of the traumatic cycles that, you know, you were placed in, as well as in your life pattern, your thought pattern. You know, those are all the things the universe is trying to teach you. You know, when you keep having things happen to you bad, back to back to back to back, you have to be able to see that, you know, there's something that you're not paying attention to, or, you know, you're doing something you need to stop doing And this is how the universe gets on trying to tell you, you know, there's a lot of things that people open up and tell me about. And it's not like, you know, I'm trying to, you know, bash them, belittle them. I'm going to tell you the truth. I know you'd rather appreciate the truth than me lying and trying to sugarcoat things. That's not what I'm here for. I'm not going to sugarcoat things because I don't want things sugarcoated for me. It's a different story when somebody's trying to belittle you or, you know, give out those passive aggressive, you know, comments. You know, I've had that before, you know, and then if you're trying to tell me you need a friend, I'm like, hold up, you ain't gonna sit up here and say this and this and that to me. I said, I don't mind people giving their, you know, corrective criticism, that is good, but don't use corrective criticism as trying to hit below the belt to some people. And people do that, you know. So it's just all these things are being taught to you for you to be able to pay attention to, for you to be able to be wiser in decisions that you make, be wiser of what you project out to the world, what your thought, you know, keeps staying stuck on, you know, because I had to really tell myself, why are you sitting up here thinking about it? And it's like, you know, something will trigger me and bring me back or whatever to one of my situations. It's like, you don't even care about that person like that on that level, so why would they even affect you in any kind of way? But it wasn't the fact of me thinking about it, it was just like allowing me to see that and then being able to release that so I can make room for love. It's just like you want all these beautiful things in your life, but you have to be able to keep focused. You know, I have to keep telling myself that whatever stressful situation is going on in your life, still keep focused on what you truly want. Don't lead your mind towards that dark path again. Don't allow yourself to go 10 paces back when you just went 20 paces forward. Because it's just those situations that we keep lingering on where we need to let go of. It's like I put that post up yesterday. I think it was yesterday, the day before yesterday. You know, when we remember our tragic situations, the tragic scenarios, it allows you to, you know, get the, you know, you're having that same feeling as if it just happened. So it's like you're torturing yourself. And I had to really do, you know, really think about it that way. Just like when I was just doing my last video, it brought up a lot of things that I forgot all about in my life that I suppressed for so long. Or, you know, I was put up under hypnosis for me not to remember, so I don't call nobody out on it. And it was just like, damn, I didn't even want to think about that. And it just brought up, it brought me right back to where I was. You know, and it was just like, you know, I had to ask the universe, thank you for allowing me to see that, you know, and please forgive me. Allow me to be able to forgive myself for allowing that to trigger me the way it did, you know, because like after I got off that, you know, after I ended the video, I cried hard. You probably see my face is still kind of red, my nose still shiny, but I had to have that good cry. You know, it's like a grief that you're, you know, you're detaching yourself away from this situation. It's just like, you know, a lot of times when I sign my name, I dread seeing my name because it's like my name, even though it brings off a lot of strength and stuff, Roslynn just endured a lot, and I'm just ready to make peace with her and part ways with her as well. So it's just like I had to talk in a third person, but being able to endure all these things, it has brought me so many positive things. I wouldn't have been able to meet y'all, you know, which was truly a blessing, being able to help others that are going through, you know, similar situations, you know, when they're not able to see the things that they need to see about themselves, and just being able to know you can reach out to me, and I'm just like, yay, I went through this, I can be able to help you, I can give you that peace and understanding to know this is the reason why you had to go through this, and this is the reason what lesson is trying to teach you. You know, but we have to be able to pay attention to the signs and know when we're stuck in a certain situation, what is that situation trying to teach us? What does the universe want us to know? You know, we want so desperately to move on to the next level, to whatever happiness you want. And the universe wants that for you too, but you can't enter that situation with still in the same thought patterns that you did before you went through your situation. I mean, for your spiritual awakening. Having the same kind of energy that you had during the times you were not fully awakened. You can't do that. You know, just like when you're trying to heal, you can't go about it like you used to from an old situation. This is a whole new different ballgame. So you have to find a different way of healing, processing things, let it go, put it in that, you know, that envelope and ship it off and just going about your business, because you truly deserve happiness in your life. But, you know, you will be stuck in your situation until you figured it out, because, you know, I'm still going through mine, but, you know, I'm like, oh, I'm okay. Even though I had my moments, I know there was things that I still needed to learn about myself that I'm healing from. So it's like a day-by-day process, but not giving up on yourself. You know, when you need to take a break, you're going to take a break. You know, take care of yourself, you know, having that self-care within yourself. That's why I take off every, you know, like 3 or 4 days, or, you know, if I really feel like, you know, I need to take a break, I'm going to take a break. But allow yourself to know the things you need to know about yourself. Heal where you need to heal from, so you can be able to get yourself, because you got blessings coming, and they're like, you're right there, but you have to be able to let all that other excess baggage go that truly doesn't seem fit for you anymore. So much love to Katie Strait, Mimi B, and Ray Fisher, and Greg, and I will talk to you on my next video. Much love, peace, be wild.